down, full range of motion, and that's the good thing about the rings, that you can get a full range of motion. Okay, and then you come up and you twist your arm. Hi, so welcome to the channel. Basically, I said the other day that I was going to do a quick thing on the rings. So here I am. I picked these up from Amazon. These are the wooden rings, really nice straps as well. They're all labeled, so you can see exactly where you want these things to be set up. So it takes 2 seconds to set them up, and they're equal, about 25 pounds. I think they're reduced from 40, 25 pounds. Very comfortable, smooth wooden rings, which work really well. So anyway, what I want to do is, after a sort of 5-10 warm up of mobilizing your body, okay, you're just going to be going to some leg swings, get everything nice and loose. The first basic move I want you to do on the rings, to get used to the rings, is just your basic squat. Okay, so, and you're going to use pretty much about 90% of the effort is going to go through the legs, 10% just to feel that sort of pull of your arms, of your back and your arms pulling up. And that's basically just your ring squat with a bit of support, a bit of stabilization. Once you've got to grips with the squat there, holding the rings, I then want the leg move, I think, which is really the best one, especially for runners, is a pistol squat. So basically, get a good strong grip, go onto one foot, and slowly drop down to your legs about 90 degrees to the floor, parallel to the floor, and then back down again the other side. Again, so you're gonna push up through your legs, through the quads, and the glutes, and the hamstrings, but you're gonna use the rings to help you back up to assist that move. So about maybe 5, 10, 15% of the effort is gonna be up on the rings to pulling up. And this is your basic alternating pistol squat. So once you've done a few squats, you can then go into pistol squats. Okay, so shoulders back, chest up. Okay, keep your chest up, down you go, and then drive up through the leg, one. And then down, and drive up, two. Keep looking forward, and three, okay? And aim for about 6 to 8, 10 reps on each leg. And that's basically your first set. Chest, once you've warmed up on the chest with some presses, two moves, okay? First one is just your basic press. Okay, down, full range of motion, and that's the good thing about the rings, that you can get a full range of motion, okay, and then you come up and you twist your arms in. Okay, so I think it's called the Bulgarian press, and up and twist the arms in. Okay, so down, full range, pause, push, twist the arms in. Your abs are tight, your glutes are tight, everything's working here to stabilize. Three, okay, so down, full range of motion, and push. Keeping your arms about 45 degree angle, and then the second push move I want you to do. And so once you're proficient with the press, and then you could do a superset here, or as a separate exercise, is go for the archer fly. So basically, it's like a sort of assisted fly movement in through the rings. So one arm comes close to the body, my left arm comes close, the right arm goes out, you're getting a nice deep stretch across the chest for that fly move there. And again, the good thing about the rings is that they have a great ability just to move around where your shoulder wants to move. There's no restriction of movement, okay? So it's a nice, easy movement. Obviously, with the rings, the further forward you are, the less weight there is on the body to press. The further back, obviously down here, it's gonna get a bit tougher because there's more weight, okay? And then the back. Now, dig your heels in, okay, into the ground. So your legs are straight, you're gonna row, elbow's gonna come back up past the ribs, and squeeze. So retract the shoulders first, and pull in, two. Okay, and all the time, everything else is quite tight. Three, your glutes and your hamstrings, as you come up, these are switched on, they're not all loosey-goosey. So that's your basic row, and again for about, start off with this about 8 to 10, and then similarly, we're gonna go for the archer fly. Again, you're gonna bring your shoulders back. One arm goes in straight to the side, one arm goes out wide. And this is gonna be a great one for the rear delts, the rhomboids, and just get that shoulders. It's a great exercise for the back. So those two back exercises, once you both, they're the great ones. Nice row into an archer fly. There, and that's your back. So then what you could do is you could put it all together. So 12 pistol squats into 12 rows, getting the elbows right back into the sides. Flip forward into 12 presses. You're getting a full rotation there again. So the whole circuit, the whole system, the whole thing becomes quite aerobic. Your heart rate's gonna get up, everything's gonna get used. But for now, I won't go into pull-ups or dips. That's another move, it's much more complex, tougher. But this is a very basic thing on rings right now, a very simple one. So those are the ones that I think you should follow. I find them extremely versatile, very easy, extremely portable, and really effective. And the thing is, you can keep progressing, because there are front levers and muscle ups and all sorts of moves that I can't do. And I'll put some links down in the description of some great YouTube sites that you should check out. But yeah, for right now when people can't get to the gym, all you need is just a tree. Just a simple tree, attached to the top there, and you set it up and you've got a full body workout, resistance, training system. It's all there, all very easy to use, and it's just your own body weight. And as I said, obviously the further forward you are, the lighter the weight is, the further back, the heavier. This is something, a very nice natural feel. And also what is pretty cool to do is if you have got time, either take them in a backpack, go for a run into the woods, find a tree, do a load of stuff, some pull-ups and dips and presses or squats, whatever you can do, and then run back. And that is the complete workout. You've got everything there. So yeah, that's a good one, or a mountain bike. But anyway, hope that's helpful. Just spend a lot of time warming up and then cooling down afterwards. If you have got elastic band, it's good to get some mobility in the shoulders, because obviously the shoulders do get used. But the good thing about the rings again is there's no fixed range of motion there. So it's good, you're gonna work that the way your body is gonna wanna work there. But keep looking forward, keep your head sort of a nice neutral alignment, keep your spine, you know, don't round your back or anything. After a good warm up, and I think you should be okay. Let me know how you get on and enjoy.